There was an idea to bring together a group of remarkable people to see if we could become something more.
So when they needed us, we could fight the battles
that they never could.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to do a top 10 list of my favorite DC movies of all time. Since there are a lot of DC movies, we're going to strictly be focusing on live action. There may be some movies that could be on my list, but since I haven't seen them, I cannot include them on my list. So for those who are commenting,
why isn't Superman on the list?
I haven't seen the movie, so I cannot put that on my top 10 list. So, let's just get started with the list, okay? Number 10 on my list is gonna be the newest DC movie that came out, which is Birds of Prey. So this movie is a lot of fun, honestly. Margot Robbie still kills it as Harley Quinn, and the whole ensemble of female heroes came together great. The movie felt a bit rushed because you only see the Birds of Prey like unite towards like the final act of the movie. Number 9 on my list is V for Vendetta. So this movie is not necessarily a direct DC movie, but it's a DC property. First saw this movie, I was like, I had no idea. I haven't read any of the V for Vendetta comics, I have no idea. My only experience of V for Vendetta was the movie, which I saw like not too long ago, but I saw like a year ago, 2 years ago, and you know. Since then, this movie blew my mind. The more you watch this movie, you realize that it is mostly a political thriller. Next up on my list, number 8, is one of the original DC movies, Batman Returns. What can't I say about this movie? This movie is one of the best comic book movies that I've seen from the Cape Crusader. Brian More Batman and they brought the best villains that I've seen, and one of the most creepiest villains, honestly. A Penguin as the main villain of Batman Returns, and I'm gonna say that guy like freaks me out. I love this movie. The success of the Batman, he says, okay, I'm gonna give you free liberties on Batman Returns, on the sequel. Do whatever you want, and maybe temper delivered. Now number 7 on my list is of course the first official modern Superman movie called Man of Steel. Now, I haven't seen the Brian Rath version of the movie, unfortunately. I've never seen Batman Returns. But when they announced that DC is gonna make their own cinematic universe to rival the MCU in 2012, I was like, okay. And they said that the first lineup is gonna be a Superman movie. I was like, okay, maybe it's gonna be good. Then 2013 arrived and the movie got released. And oh my god, this movie is madness. I love this movie. Amazing, amazing job. The villain, Jen Result, was amazing. Amy Adams as Lois Lane was decent, to say the least. She wasn't the best Lois I've seen, but she did a really good job as Lois Lane. And I love Man of Steel. Some people have said, had like negative feedback of the movie saying that, oh, there's Superman, what is Superman made a lot of destruction in Metropolis. And the movie made almost $1 billion worldwide. So whatever Zack Snyder did, worked. It didn't really work with BVS or Justice League, however, but for being the first DC movie in its new cinematic universe, it succeeded, honestly. I really love Man of Steel. Now, going back to from Metropolis to Gotham, my next movie on the list is Batman Begins. The first time I watched Batman Begins was 2007, I believe, and oh my god, this movie blew my mind. But Nolan made it this gritty, dark, realistic take on the Cape Crusader, and I lost my mind, honestly. I love the origin stories. I love Christian Bale as the Batman. Having this journey of a man becoming this dark vigilante, a protector, saint guardian, was amazing. Now moving up to the upper half of my list Now, on number 5, we have the original Batman film. What can I say about this movie? I didn't grow up with this movie. I saw this movie like years later. I saw this movie like 2011, 2010 when I bought a film. And oh my god, Michael Keaton in this movie was amazing. Jack Nicholson as the Joker, amazing. But Tim Burton did a really well job. Some people saying that Batman thing doesn't feel like a Batman movie rather than a Joker movie, because Joker is pretty much main antagonist and the main character of the movie, while Batman takes like a backseat until like the final act of the movie, where Batman takes him down. One of my favorite lines of this movie is Joker said to Bruce, saying that, "Have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight?" That line is iconic. Number 4 on my list is Aquaman. Now, this movie came out in 2018, and oh my god, those saying that Black Panther was a masterpiece with Wakanda and everything, this is DC's answer right here. Aquaman is DC's version of Black Panther. This movie was amazing. I love the visuals. If you've seen this movie on 4K, you get immersed when you're in Atlantis in the underwater environment. You were felt immersed. You can see the little bubbles in the water. Amazing job. Top-notch film. I love Aquaman. Now, next up on my list is Wonder Woman. Having a female superhero in live action was unheard of. The Wonder Woman, it was the first official modern comic book female movie that succeeded. Patty Jenkins and Gal Gadot did an amazing job. They made a perfect team. This movie blew everyone away. This movie was number one worldwide for some time, man. I love Wonder Woman. Number 2 on my list is the Joker. The Joker almost, but fraction came one of my favorite movies on the list, but it's still one of my top 2 films of the list. Now, Joker is more of a psycho thriller movie that features Arthur Fleck and his road into madness and becoming more of the Joker persona. I love this movie so much, and I was so happy that this movie won an Oscar for Best Actor with Joaquin Phoenix. I believe that he deserved that Oscar nomination. I saw this movie like 5 times because I was confused when I originally watched this movie. I was confused saying that, it wasn't the Joker. This movie was mainly about Arthur Fleck, and you only see Joker during the final act of the film. You see the actual Joker. But after rewatching this movie a lot of times and causing me to think more of the movie, this became one of my favorite films of all time. This has been my top 2 films of 2019. Number 1 becoming Avengers Endgame, but Joker was still the second best movie I've seen in 2019, and it deserved to be on number 2 on my list of best DC movies. Now you're saying
if Joker's not number 1, what is it?
Well, I would serve number 1 as one of my favorite films of all time. That is The Dark Knight. Now, what can I say about this movie? This movie is top notch. If you want to see a realistic movie, like a real crime movie that has nothing to do with comic book movies, watch The Dark Knight. The Dark Knight grabbed the superhero element and stripped it away and focused more of the crime thriller movie. This movie is a crime movie. The superhero element is second tier. Yeah, of course you see Joker and Batman, but that's the focus, the root of this movie is crime. If you see the movie The Town, which me and my nephew came out after this movie, they both have the same atmosphere. Like, they both felt like crime movies. The Joker in this movie was top notch. So sad that Heath Ledger passed away during the release of this movie, but while I was reviewing this art that Heath Ledger won an Oscar for his performance for The Dark Knight. So, having 2 actors who won an Oscar for their performance, comic book movies, deserves to be on my list. And that's it. That's how you have it. I ranked up 10 DC films of all time. Well, as of now, if you want to see a quick rundown of my top 10 list, you can see it right here. And if you want to see more countdowns and more top 10 lists, please give me that big thumbs up. Comment down below what's your favorite DC movie of all time. And while you're down there, please hit that subscribe button and the bell to get notified whenever I post, and I will see you next time. Peace.